Hello students, today I am going to discuss about friction. So let's start with the introduction of friction. What is friction? If I consider a body, a moving body which is sliding over another stationary body. Here I am considering a body which is sliding over another stationary body. This is the body 1, stationary body, and this is body 2, a moving body. After application of some force, this moving body is sliding over another stationary body. So a force exerted by this stationary body at the surface of the contact of this moving body, at this surface of contact of the moving body. So this type of resisting force is called friction force or force of friction, and it is always act in direction opposite to the direction of motion. See, if the direction of motion is this, in that condition it act opposite to the direction of motion. If I consider this motion as F, so F will be the friction force and it will act opposite to the direction of motion. We can say the friction is everywhere. In every movement there is a friction, and in all kind of machine there is a friction which is always present, and it's present, and the presence of friction would cause loss of power. It will wear out the part and it will cause the economic loss also. But if I consider some mechanical devices, so in every working device, in every mechanical device like power screws, belts and ropes, holding and fastening devices, brakes, clutches, bearing, gear, these devices, these mechanical devices always depends on friction. So we can say the friction is present in every kind of machine. It doesn't matter how accurately it was manufactured. So we can say the friction is a liability as well as the necessity. We can divide the friction in two types. We can define the friction in two ways. One is the dry friction and another is the fluid friction. Dry friction is basically friction between the surfaces, and the fluid friction is the friction between the fluid. We have to study the dry friction only in mechanics. This fluid friction is the part of fluid mechanics. We can divide this dry friction in again two types. We can subdivide this dry friction as the sliding friction and rolling friction. Sliding friction is basically the friction between two surfaces when one surface slide over each other, and the rolling friction is the friction between two surfaces which are separated by the ball and or any kind of roller. So we can say this rolling friction is always less than the sliding friction because of contact surface. To analyze the dry friction, if we are considering a block which is resting on the horizontal plane. Here, or the stationary surface. This is surface 1 and this is surface 2, and we are applying a force P on this block in this direction. We are applying a pull, or if we are applying a push on this block in this particular direction. So if the surface, when the surface is frictionless, in that condition the reaction offered by the surface is always normal to the surface, like this. Now if we are considering the surface is rough or it is not frictionless, in that condition the reaction will be unknown, in unknown direction. It will be in this direction or it will be in this direction, in any direction, that and the direction is also unknown for the rough surface. If we are considering this R and this is R, and the angle between the R and the horizontal surface, so for this condition we have to find out this reaction R and the angle. If we are considering this angle as theta, so we have to find out both R and theta both. Now if we draw the free body diagram for this condition, if we are drawing the free body diagram, this is the FBD of this condition. We have, this is the block, a moving block on this stationary surface. So we have here a W, weight of the block, that is equal to mg, and when we have the force P in this direction, and because of this surface of contact we have another reaction perpendicular to the surface and one more component of the reaction opposite to P. So this is the free body diagram of this block, and if we are considering this block is not moving, this block is not moving because of this force P, so in that condition this is in equilibrium, this is in the equilibrium, this condition is the equilibrium condition. And here F and R both are the component of the reaction due to the rough surfaces. These are the component of reactions due to rough surface. Now if we are considering here the value of P, if we are considering the value of P is 15 Newton and the body is still in static condition, the body is still not moving, so this is the condition of equilibrium, this is the state of equilibrium for this block. Now if we are again increasing the value of P, see, if we are again increasing the value of P, we are taking the value of P is 30 Newton. This is also an equilibrium condition for this block because the body is not moving. Here we can say with the increase of P, if the P is increasing, in that condition the horizontal component F will also increase. With the increase of P, the horizontal component F will also increase. Now again if we are increasing the value of P, here if we are taking the value of P equal to 80 Newton. If the value of P is 80 Newton, and if we are considering this condition is when this block or this body is just about to move, at this certain point or at this point when the value of P is equal to 80 Newton, the block is just about to move. So if we draw the free body diagram for this condition, we are taking P equal to 80 Newton. And the free body diagram, see, if we are considering this body or this block which is sliding over the stationary body is just about to move, or the block is just tend to move at P equal to 80 Newton, and this P I'm taking or I'm considering as P dash. So in this condition, the P dash here, the P dash is greater than P. In that condition, the body is just about to move. In this condition, body is just about to move. So the free body diagram for this condition will be the free body diagram. Again, here I am considering this force as P dash. Another component is weight, W equal to mg. One normal component R, and the horizontal component F dash. See, I told you with the increase of P, the value of F will also increase. So if we are considering here P dash as the value of here we are considering P dash equal to 80 Newton, so the value of F dash will also increase. So here we can say the F dash, the value of F dash will also greater than F in the condition of about to move. The body is just tend to move. Now this is the equilibrium condition. Now if we are increasing, if we are increasing this value of P dash, let's see, we are taking is 80 Newton, or we are just increasing the value of P dash by 80.5 Newton, or it is 81 Newton. So in that condition, the body will start to move. See, this is the condition. This is the condition of about to move. Now if we are increasing or we are adding plus 1 in this value of P dash, so in this condition, the body will start move. So we can say a bit smaller force is required to move the block from about to move condition. If we increase the value of P dash by 100 Newton, so in this condition, the body is in moving condition. Now let us draw the relation between P and F by a graph. I'm taking this horizontal side as the P and the vertical side as F. Here P is the force or the pull or the push on the body, and F is the horizontal component of the reaction. Horizontal component of reaction R. Now if we are taking this point as point zero, so the relation between P and F will be shown by this inclined line, and this point I am denoting as point one. So we can say, I already told you, if we increase the value of P, so the value of F varies directly with respect to P. So when we increase the value of P, the value of F or the value of this horizontal component will increase with respect to P. So this 0 to 1 is showing the equilibrium condition of the body. And at point 1, at this point 1, I'm taking the value of P as P dash. See, P dash is the value where the body is just start moving. So P dash is the value when the body is just start moving. If we increase the value of P dash by plus 1, or if we increase the value of P dash, the body will start movement. So at this point, the value of F dash will be, the value of F is given by F dash. So this relation is given by the equation F dash equal to mu s r. This value, this relation is given by mu F dash equal to mu s into r. Here, by solving the FBD, we can get the value of F dash as mu F dash equal to mu s into this r is equal to mg. So, this is the equation for F dash. Here, mu s is the coefficient of friction. Coefficient of friction for static condition. Or we can say this mu s is the static coefficient of friction. Coefficient of static friction. It is the coefficient of static friction. Now, if we increase the value of this P dash, by increasing the value of P dash, what will happen? The curve will goes like this. This is the condition when the body is about to move from 1 to 2 and from 2 to 3, the body is start moving. So at this point from 2 to 3, the body or the value of force F will obtain a steady value. So this steady value, if we are denoting as F double dash. So this F double dash is given by relation mu k r, or it is given by mu k mg. See, the body is in moving condition. So, the coefficient of friction will be the coefficient of kinetic friction. Here, mu k will be coefficient of kinetic friction. So, this relation is for static condition and this relation is for dynamic condition, where the value of F dash will be steady when the body is in F double dash. The value of F double dash will be steady when the body is in moving condition. So, here this mu s r will be the maximum horizontal component of reaction when the body is in static condition. Again, this mu k r will be the maximum horizontal component of the reaction when the body is in kinetic or dynamic condition or moving condition. In this figure, you can see the value of F is decreasing at some extent. So why the value of F, or the why this graph is going down in this figure, I will tell you. if we are considering two bodies, so the friction exists between these two bodies when these two surfaces of the body move with respect to each other. In that condition, the friction will exist. And if we are considering the body having rough surface, if we are considering rough surfaces, so these rough surfaces, if we see these rough surfaces on microscopic level, so these surfaces having ridges like this. Same thing applicable for second body. So because of these ridges or because of these irregularities in the surface and on the rough surface of the body, these surfaces will interlock. So when the body is in static condition, the interlocking force or the force force because of interlocking is larger or it is greater compared to when the body is in moving condition. So we can say the when the body is in static condition, the value of F is larger, and the body is in dynamic condition, the value of F is smaller. So that's why this curve is going down. So here the value of mu s and mu k always depends on types of surfaces and the material of the surfaces. It does not depend on area of the surfaces. So we can say it always depends on mu s and mu k, always depends on types of surfaces, and whatever material is used to make that surface, it depends on that only. It does not depends on area of the surfaces. Now so we can say this F dash equal to mu s r. This is the friction force at the instant where the body is just about to move, and this F double dash equal to mu k r is the friction force when the body is in moving condition. So this is all about the friction. See, if I take an example so you can easily understand the concept, here I'm taking a block which is having mass equal to 30 kg, and this is resting on the plane, and one pull is applied, P equal to 100 newton is applied over this block at an angle theta equal to 15 degree from the horizontal. So for this we have to find out the value of F. So we can find out the condition when at which point the body is going to start the movement. So we have the value of P here, P equal to 100 newton, so we can find out this component. So here the value of this, if we are taking this as P dash, so the P dash will be P or 100 cos 15. So this is the value, 96.59 newton. The value of P dash is this, and we have the value of M, so we can find out here the value of weight W equal to mg. If we are taking the g as 10, so it is 30 into 10, so it is 300 newton. The value of W we have, value of P dash we have. Now we have to find out the value of F. So we can apply the formula mu, this the value of mu m जी हियर वी आर टेकिंग म्यू एस बिकॉज द बॉडी वी आर कंसीडरिंग दिस बॉडी इज इन स्टार्टिंग कंडीशन एंड वी आर कंसीडरिंग द वैल्यू ऑफ म्यू एस इज 0.5 सो वी कैन फाइंड आउट द वैल्यू ऑफ एफ हियर 0.5 इनटू एमजी इज 300 सो द वैल्यू ऑफ एफ इज 150 न्यूटन सो वी कैन से इफ वी ड्रॉ द फ्री बॉडी डायग्राम Here, this is the 96.59 Newton. The value of W is 300 Newton. So, again, if we write here F and this is the reaction R. So, this also according to equilibrium condition, then this reaction will also equivalent to W or 300 Newton. Now, according to equilibrium condition, we can say the value of F is equal to the value of P dash. It will be equal to 96.59. But here we have the value of F is 150 Newton. So we can say we require here this value is 150 Newton. So we can say we require a pull more than 150 Newton so in that condition the body can move here the value of P is 96.59 and the value of F is 150 Newton so we can say the value of P will be equal to 150 Newton and at the 150 Newton the body is just about to move if we add some more force in 150 Newton, in that condition, the body will start movement. Thanks for watching the video and subscribe the channel for more lectures.